So, drawing from Max, age 10, I see a lot of suns. Max is definitely reflecting on the heat effect and how important water is to cool ourselves down, to keep our fish alive and our pets. I see a dog there. I see a lot of buildings, you know, how important it is for trees to help moderate climate. And trees and vegetation need water, and we all do, all aspects of it.
This is from Elliot, who's 11. And this obviously, if we had no water, there is no life. So he's absolutely correct there. Ice could melt, Greenland would reduce to islands, no plants, animals, or people can survive without water. Yeah, this is very dire.
That is the big challenge. And you know what Elliot, I think, is honing in on here is that when there's water crises, it's not because there's no water in the world. It's that there's no water where you need it, or there's no water of a good quality that can be used.
All right, this one is from Raymond, age 6. Looks like a lovely image of a person maybe on a beach, also potentially playing basketball. Looks like they're trying to do some recreation and, you know, probably having a tough time not having any water available. Now, that's something we do at Kleinfelder is make sure not only are we providing clean drinking water to people, but also helping to make sure that other water sources are clean as well and can be used for recreation. All right, this next one is from Oliver, age 4. The only thing I could think of was maybe it's the inside of a tuberculated cast iron water main built in the 1800s. Yeah, it's something we see a lot, especially in the Northeast. It's really old cast iron water mains with tuberculation built up on the inside that limits the capacity of the water systems and, you know, depletes our pressures and potentially water quality. So, you know, great point by Oliver. You know, not only not having it, but also having old systems that can't supply it properly to homes.
To me, it kind of looks like, you know, the oily sheen that goes on top of water. So maybe he's looking at dirty water. If you don't have clean water in abundance, you're going to have, you know, concentrated water, and it's going to get dirtier and dirtier.
Molly, age 9. Molly's presenting a really dire image here. Somebody who is really, really thirsty and having a lot of problems. A lot of people in the world, as climate change happens and desertification kind of expands, there's going to be a lot more places where there is currently water and there won't be in the future. And so hopefully, you know, people are able to be well served by those of us who are trying to solve those problems. Okay, Lincoln, age 10, he's showing the globe actually like dripping water out of the bottom of it, and a person trying to capture that water, I guess maybe trying to get the last drops. But I think with Lincoln and with the other artists that we've seen, I think a lot of kids are really starting to cue into why our infrastructure is so important, why water is so important, and we're hopefully gonna inspire a lot of other kids like Lincoln to consider fields like engineering and design and environmental planning and others that'll help to solve these problems that they're going to be really, really faced with in ways that those of us who are currently in the profession are only starting to deal with.
I love this drawing from Lincoln. It's super creative, with maybe showing humans consuming the earth's water. And I think, you know, showing us that we need to conserve, we need to protect the water that we do have for the future generations. Okay, Levi or Levy, age 9. What a great drawing, reflecting on that we need water for crops to grow, fruit, for rain, for trees, for drinking water reservoirs, maybe it looks like. And, you know, these are some of the things that Kleinfelder, we work on water supply reservoirs and integrated water planning and things that can help manage water sustainably. I think this is a great drawing.
Yeah, so this is all the things that we would not have with no water, all of our plants and fruits and reservoirs filled with water. I I like that reservoir. That is so cool. As an engineer, you know, that's kind of a cross-section, kind of how we look at reservoirs, though. I think Levy's got a parent who's an engineer. This is from Sophie, age 12. When I tell people what I do as an engineer, I often tell them, well, when you turn the tap on in the morning and the water comes out, that's because of me. And when you flush your toilet and it goes away, it's because of me. And that's the impact, you know, that she's looking at right here is her day-to-day life. And that's very true.
Sophie's showing us the whole day going through from the morning when there's not enough water for brushing your teeth or the drinking water fountain or showers. So yeah, public drinking water infrastructure is so important. I think not everybody knows it's there or appreciates it until there's a problem. So the more we can talk to kids about the importance of conserving water and protecting our resources and get them engaged in actually doing that, I think it'll be for the better.